Good morning students, welcome to my today's maths class. In the last video I explained you about set and we will understand about the set theory. Now in today's video I am going to introduce you about types of set. So let us begin our class with the introduction of the types of set. There are different types of set, that is equal set, equivalent sets, finite set, infinite set, singleton set, empty set and disjoint set and overlapping set. So now we will start with the definition of equivalent set. Here equivalent set means if two or more than two sets have equal number of elements. It means both the set have equal number of elements, so they are known as equivalent set. How? Let's see one example. If the set A is there, element of set A is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 and the element of set B is there, it is 2, 4, 6, 8, 10. When we go through set A, there are 5 elements 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 and in the set B element is there. There are also 5 elements. So according to the definition of set A, number of element in set A is equal to number of element in set B. So we can say set A is equivalent set B. This is the sign of equivalent. Now come to the second part, that is equal set. Equal set means if two or more than two sets have same elements. It means both the sets are having the same elements, so they can be known as equal set. See here, set A is given there. This is the set of 4 multiple of 2 and set B, it is a set of 4 even number, 4 first even number. So when we go through the set B, it is first 4 even numbers, that is 2, 4, 6, 8. It means the element of set A and the element of set B both are equal. So we can say that here A and B are equal sets when they are having the same elements. Now our third point is there, that is finite set. Here finite set means a set which has countable elements. In the set has countable elements. Countable elements means here we can easily count the number of element in any set. That time that set is known as finite set. So here 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. This is the set of 6 natural number. It means set A is which one? It is a finite set. Why? Because we can easily count the number of element in set A. Now come to our fourth point, that is infinite set. It is opposite of finite set. Infinite set means a set is said to be an infinite set when it has uncountable elements. It means we cannot count the number of element in set. That time that set is called infinite set. Here see one example. Set W is a set of whole numbers. When we go through this set, there is no limitation. It means it is a infinite. So we can say W is a infinite set. Why? Because there is no limit up to which number we write right, and also this is a infinite set. So now W is a infinite set. After infinite set, we will understand about singleton set. Here singleton set means it has only one element. By name also we can identify this has only one element. For example, set A is a which one? It is a smallest whole number. Set is A is the set of smallest whole number. When we go through the whole numbers, that is 0, 1, 2, 3, 4 up to infinite. And which one is the smallest number? So set A is has only one element, that is 0. This is known as singleton set. Singleton set means only one element. Now go to the second point, that is empty set. Empty set means by name also we can identify. Empty means there is nothing. So we can say it is a set which has no elements. Now here two more important things are there. Empty set is also known by the name of null set, and also it is called void set. And one more thing is there. Empty set is defined by this sign, or we can say by this sign. This is a phi. It is a symbol of empty set. Let's see one example. Set A is there. It is a set of prime number which is less than 2. Prime number, this is the set of prime number less than 2. When we go through the set of prime numbers, 2 is the smallest prime number, and there is no number which is less than 2. So it means there is no element. This is the empty set. Now we will understand about the disjoint sets. Disjoint set means if two or more than two sets have no common elements, so the sets are known as disjoint set. For example, if the element of set A is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 and the element of set B is there, it is small a, small b, small c and small d. When we compare both the element, both the sets, so they are having the different element. There is no common element. This is the set of natural numbers and this is the set of alphabet. So here A and B have no common element. So we can say these are, which one? A and B are known as disjoint set. Now our next point is overlapping sets, that is two or more than two sets are known as overlapping sets if they have at least one common elements. They have at least one common elements. They have at least one common element. So here when set A is there, it is the set of four starting natural number, and set B is there, this is the set of multiple of 4 multiple of 2. Here which number is common? 2 and 4. So A and B have 2 and 4 as a common element. So what we say, set A and set B, both are which type of set? Both are overlapping sets. So I hope you understood about the different types of sets. In this video, we will understand about We understood about the equivalent set, equal sets, finite set, infinite set, overlapping sets, disjoint sets, empty set, and singleton set. Now we are going to start exercise number 4.3, which is based on the different types of sets. This is our exercise number 4.3, and that is our question number 1. Identify if the following pair of sets are equal. So with the help of definition of equivalent set, we can do this question. Question number 2 is there. Identify if the following pair of sets are equal. And our question number 3 is there. Classify the given sets as a singleton and empty sets. Here, question number 4 is also there, which is classify the given sets as a finite and infinite set. So this is the exercise number 4.3, which is fully based on the types of set. Now let's start one by one. This is our question number 1, part A. Question number 1 is there. Identify if the following pairs of sets are equivalent. It means two sets A and B are given there, and here we will identify both the sets are equivalent or not. So for identifying the equivalent set or not, we need to find out the number of element in each set. So when we find out the number of element in set A, how many elements are there? 1, 2, 3, 4 and 5. And the element of set B, it is 1, 2, 3 and 4. So number of element in set A is not equal to number of element in set B. So we can say that A and B are not, which one? They both are not equivalent set, because they are having the different number of element. Now come to the C part. We will not do B part, because the B part is the same part like a part A. In the C part, set A and set E and set F is given in the set builder form. So first we need to convert into roster form, then we will identify the given sets are equivalent sets or not. This is the C part. There are two sets are given. Set A, it is a set of prime factors of 20. So first we will identify the element of set E. Prime factor means the number in which table 20 will become. So this is 1, 2, 4. The element or prime factors are 1, 2, 4, 5. Then after 10 and 20. So how many elements are there? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 and 6. Now that is our second point. It is set F. In the set F, when we go through the set F, this is the multiple of 5 but less than 40. So it is 5, 10, 15, 20, 25, 30 and 35. Element of set E, these are the factors of 20. It means in the table of 1, 2, 4, 5, 10 and 20. 20 will become in the table of these numbers. And the element of F is there, 5, 10, 15, 20, 25, 30, 35. Why we don't write here 40? Because the value of X is less than 40. So number of element in E, how many elements are there? 6. And the number of element in F, it is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. When we see the number of element in set E and set F, this is not equal. So what we say? Both the sets are not equivalent. Now come to the D part. This is our G part. D part. In the D part, two sets are there, G and H. Set G, it is a set of letter in the word social, and set H, that is the letter in the word science. So now G, for G set, word social is there. So how many letters are there? We will write down here. S-O-C-I-A-N-L. Element of set G. It is S-O-C-I-A-N-L. But when we see set H, there are elements are there. S-C-I-E-N. Here, I told you when I explain you about the definition of set, repetition of element is not allowed. Here, C is given two times, so we will write down only single time. E is given two times, so we will write down here only single time. Now, the element of number of element in set G. How many elements are there? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. And the element of H. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. This is only 5. So set G and set H. Both are having the different elements. So they are not equivalent. I hope you will understood about the question number 1. Now come to the question number 2. This is our question number 2, B part. In the question number 2, we will identify the given sets are equal sets or not. So first we will write down the both the given sets in the roster form. This is the set number C. When we go through the set C, here one word is there, that is count. But it is a set of vowel in the word count. So which elements are there as a vowel? O and U. So element of set C, this is O and U. And the element of set D, this is also the vowel in the word right. There are two vowels, I and E. So element of D is there, only two elements, I and E. So the element of C and D are different. So what we say? We say both the sets are not equal. Here elements of C and D are different, so they are unequal. What we say? Both the sets are unequal set. It means they are not equal sets. Now one more part we will do. Yes, look at here. This is the question number 2, C part. In the question number 2, C part, there are two sets. Set E, this is an set of odd numbers, which is condition is there. The value of odd number is there more than 5 and less than 15. And the second thing is there, set F. In this set, this is the even number but bigger than 5 and less than 15. So element of set E, it is an odd number but more than 5. So which number is there? 7, 9, 11 and 13. And the element of F is there, it is more than 5, 6, 8, 10, 12 and 14. We know about odd numbers are 1, 3, 5, 7, 9, 11, 13, 15, 17 up to infinite. But here, why we take only this 4 element? Because this is an set of odd numbers and limitation is given there. It is less than 15 and bigger than 5. So we will write down these numbers. And for the set F, this is also an even number, but it is more than 5 and less than 15. So up to 6 to 14 we will write down. When we compare the element of set E and F, both are different. So this is not a equal set. What we write down? Set E and F are not equal. Why? Because they are having the different element. I hope you understood about equal sets. Now go through the question number 3. This is our question number 3, and question number 3 is there, classify the following sets as a singleton set and empty set. Here we will solve two part, that is part A and part B. In the part A is there, that is the set of all negative natural numbers. So when we see natural numbers are not negative, it means there is no element. So how can we write down this set? This is without element. Why? Natural numbers are there, which is known as positive integer also. So here it is empty set. So what we write down? This is the empty set. And the second thing is there, second part is there, that is the set of whole number which is less than 1. We know about the set of whole numbers. Which numbers are there? 0, 1, 2, 3 up to infinite. But this is the set of whole number which is less than. Which number is there less than 1? It is 0. So set A is there. It is only 1 element. So what we say? Number of element is there 1. It means this is the singleton set. So with the help of these formulas or this definition, you can identify the singleton set and the empty set. Now come to the last question, that is our question number 4, and in the question number 4, which is depend on definition of finite and infinite set. Question number 4, A part is there. This is the set of all the factors of 100. When we see the factors of 100, there are infinite number of factors of 100. Infinite number of factors of 100, we can say or not? No. Which one is the last factor? 100 is the last factor of the number. When we go through the factors of number, in which number 100 will become, in which table of number 100 will become, so that is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 10, 20, then after 20, after 25, 50, or we can say another one is there, here 20, 25, then 50. These numbers are there in which 100 will come. So we can easily count the number of element or not? See, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 and 9. We can easily count the number of element in set. So it is a which one? It is a countable element. So what we say? This is a which type of set? It is a finite set. And when we see the B part, set of all the multiple of 4. All the multiple of 4 here, when we see the B part, multiples of 4, limitation is not given. There are so many multiples are there, okay. This is a infinite number of multiple of 4. So this is a infinite set because the limitation is not given. And in the factors of 100, we can easily count the number of element, that is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 and 9. So this is the countable element. So we can say this is the finite set. But in the last one, in the B part, there are more infinite number of multiple of 4 and limit is not given. So this is the uncountable set and we can say this is the infinite set. Here our question number 4 is over. In the next video, we will understand about the another chapter. Here our question number, chapter number 4 is completed. I hope you understood about all the things. So now do the hard work and do well and have a nice day.